welcome to the Shirley Thomas Show. I'm Shirley Thomas, your hostess, and it is indeed a pleasure to be coming into your lives by way of eLife Media. This is my first show, so I think it's only fitting that I give you an introduction of what the vision of this show is all about. We teach successful principles on having a happy, fantastic, phenomenal life, and we highlight others who are doing astounding things to change and touch people's lives, and we invite them to be on the show, and we say thank you for all that you do. Well, where do I get my successful principles from? I get them from the Word of God. No better place, I tell you. And just before we were coming on, it said they were playing some very, very mellow jazzy music. And I said, oh, okay, that's fitting, because serving the Lord Jesus Christ is mellow. It's one of the most mellowest, I'm creating another word, I'm sure, thing that an individual can do is when they have the Lord Jesus Christ in their lives. He is the reason for living. He gives us hope and new meaning to our lives each and every day. Well, I was asking the Lord, what is it, Daddy, do you want me to share with your audience today and your people? And he said, go to the book of Psalms, Psalms 23. So we all know about Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want, right? Ha, ha, ha. Well, let's see what Daddy is saying to us, the Heavenly Father is saying to us through the Word of God. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. In another version, it says, the Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. And then there's another version that says, the Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. I like all three. There's nothing like the living Word of God that helps you to live day by day by day in a victorious state of mind, because that's what serving God is. It's victory in all areas of your life. Now, God is not a defeated God. His son Jesus is not a defeated son or Lord or Savior. So why should we be those who are made in his likeness and his image? And so it's very fitting when we can say, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. Well, somebody might be saying out there, I'm experiencing some wacky stuff. I mean, it's every time I turn around, there's something going on. Ugh. It's just topsy-turvy. Is it ever going to get better? And then you tell me that the Lord is telling me. Well, let's just read the next scripture where he says, he makes me to lie down in green pastures, and he leads me beside the still waters. Now you telling me in the midst of my going through all this stuff that I am being led by still waters and I'm lying down in green pastures? Well, this scripture reminds me of one over in the book of Ephesians where it talks about he has made it possible for us to sit in Christ Jesus in heavenly places. Well, you might ask the question, how in the world could you be sitting in heavenly places when you are sitting in the studio of eLife Media on television? Heaven is up in the sky. The last time I checked, ha, ha, ha. Well, That behooves me to let you know that these scriptures have another meaning that is higher than our finite minds. The leading us by still waters, the causing us to lie down in green pastures, and the sitting of our, and the statement, shall I say, of our sitting in heavenly places in Christ Jesus is a state of being that you could use this vivid, powerful imagination of yours and be in the midst of turbulence, be in the midst of interesting challenges, be in the midst of every time I turn around. Yet, still sitting in heavenly places in God. I mean, peace in the midst of confusion. Peace in the midst of a storm. Your neighbors and your friends looking at you like, how could you be still smiling with all that's going on? Because I'm sitting in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. In my mind, I am with my daddy, and he has told me that I will deliver you out of every affliction, not just one. In my mind, I'm sitting with my daddy, and he has told me that I am more than a conqueror through Jesus Christ who loves me. In my mind, I'm sitting in heavenly places. And my daddy has told me in the book of Revelation that I win at this game called life. And so that's why I can boldly say that the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. The Lord is my shepherd, and in that need, I am lying down in green pastures. All right now, hey. In that need, I am sitting by still waters. The Lord is our shepherd. We have everything we need. He makes us rest in the meadow grass, and he leads us by the quiet streams. So if there is turbulence going on, if all hell has broken loose, if that son or that daughter is still out there acting crazy, you need to pull from the greater one inside of you and turn around and take a praise break and tell the adversary, I don't look at what I see, but I look at what I don't see. And Judy is traveling all over the world ministering in song with that anointed, beautiful voice that you gave her. Even though in the natural, she still may be out there. I'm resting in the heavenly place of that place where God told me that I could call those things that be not as though they were. I'm resting in that heavenly place where he told me, don't look at the things that you see, but look at them because they are only temporal.
But look at the things that you don't see, because they are eternal. And tell your flesh, and tell your mind, because that's where the battle starts, in the mind. We get the victory over this mind and start speaking stuff like God says. Speak the word of God. What does it mean to have the God kind of faith, y'all? To have the God kind of faith is to say what God says. Are we walking around here saying all this other crazy stuff that don't amount to a hill of beans? Say what God says. That's having the God kind of faith. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. He makes me rest in the meadow grass, and he leads me by the quiet streams. Amen? Ha, 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 ha. Not only that, but he restores our soul. He leads us in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. He leads us in the path of right living. You know, God says something to me all the time. He says, Shirley, if you want to have a good life, follow instruction. I'm going to say the same thing to you. If you want to have a good life, follow instruction. What instructions am I talking about? The instructions that come from the Word of God, the recipe for life. It will cause you to have the goodness. It will cause you to know that goodness and mercy is following you all the days of your life. It will cause you to know that there are 72,000 angels encamped around about you everywhere you go, keeping you in all your ways, and that everything that concern of you has already been perfected. But we got to say it, because when you say it, that means you're speaking what God says, and that means you're having the God kind of faith. Okay? All right, now. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. It sounds like there's a will going on here to me. Now, you can will to be scared when you walk outside, or you can will to have faith to know that I shall not fear any evil. God made us free moral agents. He gave us. We're the only ones that have the ability to choose. Animals cannot choose. And so every day, Daddy has set before us some choices. I set before you life, and I set before you death. I set before you good, and I set before you evil. You choose this day that you and your seed may live. I'm here to tell you that your choices that you make on a daily basis not only affects you, but it affects your children and your children's children and your children's 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 children. The Bible says, down to 10 generations. And I can't think of anybody in their right mind knowing, having your senses keen, that you can discern good from evil, would want to live a bad life, would want to make bad choices. would want to do things to hurt yourself or hurt those that you love. It's just you need, I'm going back to that thinking. I'm going back to that powerful apparatus that you have called the mind. You need it transformed so that you can know what's good and do a lot of that. You need it transformed so that you can know what's evil and do a lot of that. And then, and only then, can one walk down the road of righteousness. Walk down the road of right living. Walk down the road of wholeness, completeness, soundness. Daddy told us in the Word, I've given you power. I have not given you the spirit of fear. We're going right back to, I will fear no evil. I have not given you the spirit of fear, but I've given you the spirit of power and of love and of a sound mind. Another virgin say, a sane mind, a controlled mind, a mind that does not want you to play tit for tat. Or you did it to me, I'm gonna do it back to you. All right, I'm gonna get you. Oh, no, 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 no. God says in the Word that revenge is mine. Revengeance is mine. I shall repay. Whoever wronged you or hurt you, leave it in the hands of the Lord. I guarantee you, it is a terrible thing to fall into the hands of an angry God. And he can take care of Joe Blow and Judy Jones much better than you and I. I remember something David said when he erred and he made a mistake. And David made what one would call an atrocious mistake. David was out on his balcony. He looked over into the courtyard or beyond, and he saw a beautiful woman. He said, I want her. Now here is the king of the whole palace. Can have any handmaiden he wants, but he wanted that one. And when he erred and he made a mistake, and the prophet came to him and told him that God has seen the error of your ways, and he has given you several choices of how you should be chastised. Which one do you want? David said, I'd rather fall into the hands of God than into the hands of man. Because even in the midst of God chastising me, he will still have mercy on me. Isn't that astounding? This God who is our shepherd, who watches over our soul, who leads us beside still waters, who causes us to graze in the green grass, still is merciful to us in the midst of his having to chastise us or correct us. Think about us in the natural and we correct our children. We have to do it, the Bible says, and it's for their learning. God does it because he wants you to experience that good life, that life that causes you to walk down the path of righteousness And that life that causes you to experience his wholeness, his greatness, his completeness. I said at the beginning that he's mellow. Ha, 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 I like that. And it's mellow. I cannot think of anyone else, y'all, that has your best interests at heart like God does. He got your back. All he wants for you is good. Man is quite interesting. Flesh is quite interesting. Many times, often not, or often so, there is an ulterior motive around flesh or human frailty. But God has only one motive, and that is that you have life and have it more abundantly. Isn't that wonderful? You got somebody who got your back, and all he wants you to do is live. The songwriter said, look and live. Look to Jesus now and live. It's according to his word. Hallelujah. All you got to do is look and live. Going right back to what he said in the word. I'm your shepherd. I have everything you need. If you need life, I got it. If you need peace, I got it. If you need wholeness, I got it. If you need joy, I got it. If you need provision, I got it. All you have to do is come to me. Come to me, all ye that are heavy laden and weary. And I, heavy laden, and I will give you rest unto your soul. God is saying, come, come, let me be your shepherd. Let me be the one that supplies your every need. Let me be the one that take you up in my arms and tell you that it's all right. We can make it. I got this. Let me be the one that tell you there's no demon, no devil, no spirit, no power, no principality stronger than me. And if I am for you, I'm more than the whole world against you. For I am your shepherd, and I have everything you need. I am your shepherd, and I let you rest at the meadow streams. God bless you. We love you here at the Shirley Thomas Show. We appreciate you tuning in. We're going to take a break and come back in about 5 minutes. God bless now. Bye-bye. But And welcome back to the second portion of the Shirley Thomas Show. And that second portion is where we highlight others who are doing astounding things to change and touch people's lives, and we invite them to be on the show. I'm always astounded of how the Heavenly Father allows me to grace the presence of such phenomenal people. And when I listen to their testimonies of the things that they've done, their educational background, and the hoops that they jump through, it's always a pleasure to learn, grow, and glean from them. Well, I have with me on my very first show, Miss Linda Washington. And so let me read a little something to you about her, and then we'll bring her on. Miss Washington has 4 CD recordings to her credit, the latest being a single from her upcoming sophomore solo project that was released on November 14th, entitled I'll Praise Him. The CD has a bonus track that is a beautiful worship song entitled We Give You Praise. She is currently working on a 5th recording, which is due out in the spring of 2016. Miss Washington was the founder and director for the internationally acclaimed Tri-Area Community Choir, a recording mass choir known for singing diverse music, including anthems, hymns, spirituals, contemporary, traditional and inspirational gospel music. Well, Miss Washington has a page of a lot of astounding accolades. We could go on and on and on, but I think we would rather like to hear her talk about it as opposed to me reading it. Linda, yes. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, and thank you for having me on your show.
You're welcome. Linda, you have just simply astounded me when I listen to your testimony of a lot of things that you have gone down through life and your background and your education and what have you. Let me just start out by saying that you are president
and CEO of Lasco Incorporated. Yes. Tell us a little something about Lasco and how it got started.
Well, Lasco got started out of a need for me to share with youth options in music, mm-hmm. specifically gospel music. Mm-hmm. So I started a 501c3 company to do just that, to be able to share music production, letting youth know that there are other options to just singing or playing. Mm-hmm. The behind the scenes things are just as important, producing and the like, and being able to educate them on that, and to also be able to write, produce, market, and distribute music. Mm-hmm. So doing all of that through Lasco is how it got started. Mm-hmm. And then from that, it branched off into some other things, to do information technology consulting, music consulting, and fitness consulting.
Okay. Well, I didn't read everything that was on the page, Linda, but as I read it a little bit earlier, I noticed that you've been singing or love having a love for music ever since you was a child. Tell us about that.
That's true. I started singing when I was 2 years old. Mm. I started banging out music on the piano when I was 4, mm-hmm. and I started playing professionally at 6. Mm. Yes.
Wow.
I've been
wow.
at it a long time.
Uh-huh.
And this year I celebrate 55 years in music ministry.
Well, congratulations.
So I've been doing it a long time.
Congratulations. Well, what is your business and your professional background and how it ties in with the music and other things that you do?
Well, knowing that music was in my blood because my mother was a minister of music, my grandmother was a minister of music, I grew up around church music all the time, so mm-hmm. my mother made all 7 of us take piano lessons from the time we were in elementary school all the way up to high school. Mm-hmm. So, of course, she thought I was going to major in music. Well, I wanted to be a doctor, mm-hmm. so I decided that I was going to minor in music and go into biology, more so chemistry. And I had a full ride to the University of Georgia for a medical college, mm-hmm. and she didn't want me to go away because I was only 16. Mm-hmm. So I stayed in Savannah, Georgia, which is where I'm from, and got my bachelor's undergraduate degree there, mm-hmm. and at Savannah State University. And after I got my degree, I decided, well, I think I'm going to be a chemist for a while, mm-hmm. but I was still doing music the entire time. I've always played for churches. I've always sung. And of course, I've always branched out to do other genres of music. Mm-hmm. So that's been my life. Mm-hmm. I've done it ever since I was small and still doing it again today. Mm-hmm. So as it would turn out, after being a chemist, being the outgoing person that I am, got a little tired of the test tubes and white jackets mm-hmm. and in the lab. And at the time when I was in college, I got a minor in math as well, mm-hmm. and I was learning computer mm-hmm. programming. Mm-hmm. So didn't have it as a degree, but I did take a lot of courses. Mm-hmm. So I decided to get out of chemistry and get into technical IT programming.
Okay.
And of course, I got bored with that. Mm-hmm. Doing all of this coding mm-hmm. for major corporations mm-hmm. and decided I wanted to do more marketing because I was just an outgoing person. And I got into marketing, and I spent 33 years in corporate America, ending up my career doing mostly sales and marketing.
Oh, okay.
All over the world selling computer systems.
Well, you know what, Linda? It sounds like to me, out of all the things we do in life, it takes a full circle right back to what God has called us to do, doesn't
Absolutely.
It? Which was music.
Absolutely.
That's your love and your passion.
That's right.
All right now.
Yes.
Linda, I would like for you to do me a special favor because I heard something you said a moment ago that was so key, that you were made to take music lessons when you were a child. You started singing when you were 2 years old. How oftentimes there are small children who have gifts, yet maybe the parents are so busy with providing a life
and a roof over their head, that they don't stop and look at that child, study that child, analyze that child, and pour into what they see so that they can have multiple choices like you did when you got older. What would you say to young mothers and dads about their youngsters right now, the importance of steering them and pouring into them and their life today and bringing up kids is so much different than ours when we brought up kids. And it seems like it's an interesting challenge, but it still goes back to the word that was taught earlier, our shepherd will help us.
Absolutely.
What can you say encouraging to parents?
Well, I would say to parents that allow your child to be a child, mm-hmm. and remember that you are the parent, mm-hmm. and you are to lead them and guide them with God's help. Mm-hmm. And when you're coming up in your child, children don't have choices. You make choices for them, mm-hmm. because at their age, they're not always in a position to make a correct choice. Mm-hmm. So I would say, make choices for your children, recognize their gifts at an early age, and allow them to just soar, mm-hmm. pour into them, and help them to do things that they are passionate about. Because I always had that opportunity, and I just thank God that I'm still doing what I'm purposed to do and what I was created to do from the time I came out of the womb.
That's a blessing.
Yeah,
that's a great blessing. Yes. My hat's off to you, Linda. It really is. Okay, what are your business goals for 2016?
Well, you mentioned the recording project, and it's actually due out the end of the summer, so I'm working on that. So as far as Lesco is concerned, we're going to try and get that product out. I'm also mentoring some young people. You mentioned that. One of the things that I've been called to do is to work with youth, mm-hmm. and I am mentoring some youth to help them in the music industry and to get their product out. So I've created a group of early 20s teenagers that I actually had the pleasure of working with and cultivating them, mm-hmm. because they came into my youth choir not having any children. I said, okay, Lord. So he says, okay, I'm going to make you the ministry head for this youth choir. And he only gave me 85 of them. I was like, okay, Lord, I didn't really ask for 85. But, okay. You know, you've become mother, aunt, and, you know, just mentor, mm-hmm. counselor, mm-hmm. for those. And a lot of those youth that I've had the opportunity to sow into their lives musically are still with me today and mm-hmm. calling me mom, and I'm mentoring them. So it gives me pleasure to be able to help them get out there and mm-hmm. to show them what's the right thing to do and the right approach from a musical standpoint.
Oh, yeah.
So music is one area, and fitness is another area. I've been doing fitness for over 20 years, mm-hmm. and one of the things that caused me to focus more on Lasco and getting out of corporate America, I was in a very bad car accident right on Route 50, a mile from my exit getting out on Bowie. Mm-hmm. And it was raining, and I hydroplaned, and I ran into a bulldozer, a construction site, at about 60 miles per hour. So I crushed the entire front of my vehicle, and it landed on the side. Had 10 brakes on one side. I broke both my legs. I broke, my right foot was kind of detached. They had to reattach it. My knee was broken in 3 places, my thigh in 2 places, my hip in 2 places, and my arm. So after that, I was like, you know, God has a sense of humor. If you don't do what he tells you to do, he'll just shut you down for a minute. I mean, surely I can do nothing but raise my right hand and call on the name of Jesus. I was bedridden. I couldn't do anything. So there I was, helpless, a person who was, you know, playing competitive tennis, who was praise team one night, playing for 3 churches, youth choir, regular choir, just playing golf, just active. Now I'm laying in a bed where they said I wasn't going to make it, I wasn't going to live, I wasn't going to walk again. And 2.5 months later, I went from being bedridden to the wheelchair, to the walker, to the crutches, to the cane, and to be able to walk again.
Thank you, Jesus.
It gives me a lot of pleasure to be able to do fitness. because having all of the disabilities that I've had and the obstacles, I'm able to share with a lot of seniors and young people, even with disabilities. I teach now 12 classes a week. I teach aqua classes, I teach land classes, and I teach Zumba classes. I'm a licensed Zumba instructor. I teach Zumba toning, I teach aqua Zumba, Zumba for kids, Zumba gold for seniors. And you know, I just love what I do. So in addition to doing my music, one of the other big areas where I give back is in fitness. And I'm looking forward to expanding that and doing a fitness video. They actually asked me to make one. And hopefully having my own fitness show and fitness clothing line.
All right.
So that's fitness. And then the other part of it is wealth building. So I've been doing that and trying to share.
Before you go into the wealth building, Linda, I think this would be a great time for you to just simply say how that you can be contacted, because you gave us so much information. I think this would be a great time to tell the audience how they can contact you, because you gave us such great information about the fitness and da-da-da-da-da. And fitness is definitely needed in the Afro-American nationality and all nationalities, as a matter of fact. Especially as we mature, we want to still be able to get around and do for ourselves. So let the people know how they can reach you.
Well, it's very easy. My name is Linda Washington. You can go to MissLindaWashington.com. That's M-S, Linda with an I, Washington as in D.C., .com. And my email address is actually MissLindaWashington@gmail.com.
All right.
So you can contact me that way. And for those people who are into fitness, you can also go to LindaW.Zumba.com, and it gives you my entire schedule of what I'm doing.
The Linda Washington, right?
Miss Linda Washington.
Miss
M-S. LindaWashington.com. Miss LindaWashington at gmail.com.
All right. All right, I'll let her say it. And then we were beginning to talk about wealth building.
Yes, yes. I'm an entrepreneur at heart. And, you know, with everything we do, we need finances. You know, finances. To
the Bible
live.
Says money answers a lot of things.
Yes, it does.
I remember.
Not all things, but a lot of things.
A lot of things.
And
I remember something that Tony Robbins said, the motivational speaker. He said, money doesn't bring you happiness. He said, but it sure feels good when you drive up in a limousine and you're trying to solve some of the problems that can happen in life, and you got the money to help you. He says it's a good feeling.
Absolutely.
But go ahead.
And yeah, to be able to build wealth and to be able to sow into the kingdom and to be able to sow into so many people's lives who actually need it is an important thing. And I think we as a people don't do enough to build wealth. I like the 80-10 plan. 10% to God, 10% to savings, and live off of 80. If you're not living off of 80% of what you're bringing in, Houston, there's a problem. And if you don't have at least 6 to 12 months of your savings to be able to carry your bills for that time, there's a problem. Because what happens if life happens and there's a catastrophe and there you are. Who are you going to call on? It's good to be self-sufficient. And do you know anybody who would pay your mortgage for 12 months? Pay your bills for 12 months? So it's good to be able to establish wealth. And if you've been dealing with the market, I've been telling people for months now that it's getting ready to crash again. Trust me, it happens. There's a pattern to it and with wealth. And it's going to happen again, and it would be to your advantage to try and see how you can do some things to try and build wealth. Well, I've been doing a lot of multi-level marketing types of things and investment type of things, and lost a lot of money in the stock market with the last crash. And I'm deciding this time I'm going to do things a little bit differently, pairing up with people who are experts in that area, and seeing what they do and seeing what works for them, and then being able to share it to the masses. So in every portfolio, There should be currency. Mm-hmm. There should be precious metals. Mm-hmm. And you should have a diverse portfolio. In order to do that, you need to establish some cash. How are you going to get it? Mm-hmm. Most people are working a job. I say J-O-B stands for just over broke. Mm-hmm. Oh, another friend says jump out of bed. Uh-huh, yeah, some of us have the luxury of working at home mm-hmm. now, but still, well, you're working for someone else.
Let me tell you something, Linda. You know, I was telling, you know, some of my coworkers, I said there are people sitting in their pajamas at the computer every day bringing in bukus of money.
That was me. Mm-hmm. My last 12 years of my career, mm-hmm. I had to maintain an office at home. Mm-hmm. Okay, yes, mm-hmm. I was a six-figure, I was making six figures in the 80s. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I was like, hey, mm-hmm. It was nice to be able to call my own shots. Mm-hmm. The closest thing I had to having my own business was having a job mm-hmm. that allowed me to make unlimited income. Mm-hmm. As much as I can sell, mm-hmm. that's what I could make. Mm-hmm. But even though I brought in the $1 billion contract, I still didn't get enough of that $1 billion, Shirley. Mm-hmm. So so what do? Mm-hmm. You go out and you try and do some other things, mm-hmm. diversify, mm-hmm. and make it for yourself as a business owner, because the business owner is the one that's going to be making the bulk of the money. Mm-hmm. There's a reason why 1% of the persons in the world own the bulk of the wealth. Mm. They're business owners, you better believe it.
So we have a little saying that we say, having a job is noble, owning your own business and mm-hmm. building wealth is exciting.
Absolutely.
Building wealth, you're able to do so many other things other than just your immediate needs.
Absolutely.
You're ever, like you say, able to help someone else.
Absolutely.
Yeah, wow. Absolutely. But go ahead, continue on.
So I guess this the latest thing that I'm doing now that I've gotten involved with in the past year mm-hmm. was this Simple Road to Wealth Club. Mm-hmm. It sparked my interest because it was based on the spiritual principle of sowing and reap. Mm-hmm. Now, my pastor did a series on sow and reap, mm-hmm. and the series lasted about 8 weeks. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I was like, this is worth taking a look at, mm-hmm. because surely if you sow, you're going to read.
You're going to read.
And the whole concept behind this program was everyone was a business owner, mm-hmm. but they patterned this business after some spiritual principles and really universal principles, mm-hmm. and taking a community approach. You know, there are some people who have really mastered being able to take this community approach of buying and selling from each other, mm-hmm. and keeping it in the loop with each other, mm-hmm. and they are continuing to be prosperous. Mm-hmm. What a pattern, mm-hmm. and what a thing to do. So in this particular business, everyone is a business owner, but they're also a client. Mm-hmm. If you are a baker, I'm going to buy my bread from you. Mm-hmm. If I'm a cobbler, you're going to buy your shoes from me. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we all feed into each other. Mm-hmm. But the other thing that really got me is you came out of pocket one time mm-hmm. with a nominal yeah. investment, mm-hmm. and within your first transaction as a business owner, your clients, you got your money right back. Mm-hmm. And everything else mm-hmm. that you spent was out of your profit.
Wow.
I've never seen anything like it. I've spent thousands of dollars mm-hmm. in multiple products, things I still have mm-hmm. sitting on the shelf that I'm not using. Mm-hmm. And the only thing I'm asked to do is share this and promote club membership. Mm-hmm. Me being a sales and marketing person, I told people I could sell ice to an Eskimo. But this isn't really a sales job. I mean, I spend $50 on lunch. Mm-hmm. You know, this is something that's well within reach mm-hmm. of the average person mm-hmm. to be able to attain mm-hmm. some wealth mm-hmm. in a short period of time. Yeah, it's just phenomenal.
Well, you know, I really believe that we're living in the season and time where people are looking now and their minds are open to more diverse things because people are getting laid off. You saw what happened today in the mm-hmm. news with Great Britain just simply dropping out and stock just went down. Mm-hmm. And one of the news stations said, well, your 401k dropped about $2,700. Isn't that something?
Mm-hmm. It happened to me. It happened before to me. That's why I was like, oh, this is not the answer. Oh, no.
Business ownership.
Got me once. You will not get me twice. All business ownership, taking your resources and diversifying. I say that's how a lot of foreigners, where their dollars have crashed, are able to maintain. It wasn't because of their currency. It was because they had a diverse portfolio. And I'll just mention one person that I really, as one of my mentors, Jewel Tankard, who is on Bravo, the Tankard Show. And she said she hung around with people who were economists, billionaires, to tell her how to do this and trying to make things and reach for the average person, like buying gold. The average person don't realize that they can actually do their savings in gold versus putting it in the bank or the stock market or your 401k, because the market can crash. You can take your gold anywhere and it will still be of value. Matter of fact, it's gone up. So
as of today.
It was protected.
Wow. I feel the renewing in my mind, even as you're talking. And it is so key that we get around people who are talking these kinds of things instead of talking what we see going on in the economy.
Absolutely.
Because it is real in the news that that's happening, but there's some things that you can focus on, like you say, to keep you above all of that.
Absolutely.
And that's diversifying.
That's right.
Going into your own business. Learning how to create wealth with the little bit that you have.
Absolutely. It can be done.
It can be done.
It can be done.
It can be done. Ah, so where can we find out more about the Simple Road to Wealth?
Well, right now we're having biweekly meetings at 6:45 on Saturdays at Largo Community Church, which is not far from here. It's right on Enterprise Road. And I love the club meetings. We come in at 6:45. We meet and greet. Presentation starts at 7. And it does start at 7. We are on time group. It lasts for about 45 minutes, 15 minutes of questions and answers. We out the door. That's it.
And that's at Largo Community Church.
It's located at 1701 Enterprise Road here in Mitchellville, Maryland.
And it will be the next one on Saturday, and that date is?
And actually, I'm giving the presentation on Saturday.
Okay,
that's so June 25th. June 25th.
All right, June 25th, Largo Community Church at 6:45, talking about wealth building, Simple Road to Wealth. Well, tell us a takeaway for our audience out of all that we heard and learned about you today. What would you want to be the takeaway for the listening audience?
Well, I would encourage everyone to not put off for tomorrow what you can do today, because tomorrow is not promised to you. I was at a funeral today, and that topic, I mean, I actually, one of the songs I sang was Safe in His Arms, which talks about the 23rd song. The Lord is my shepherd, and He has everything that I need.
Yeah.
So I would ask that you would get knowledge, take that knowledge and act on it, and act now and don't wait, because tomorrow may be too late.
I want to say to you that I wrote a book called Success for a Living. And in that book, I said that the world has taken the these and thous out of the Word of God and made billions of dollars. All right? It said, and we as the body of Christ must take the Word of God and confess it and bring in our billions.
Speak it into existence.
It told us to write goals, okay? Where do you want to be in 5 months, 6 months, 1 year, 5 years?
That's
well, the Lord told us to write the vision and
make it plain.
And it's yet for an appointed time.
That's right.
That's nothing but the Word of God.
That's right.
And so we're coming to a close right here at the Shirley Thomas Show. And we thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
You can reach us at successfilledliving@gmail.com. Successfilled, F-I-L-L-E-D, living@gmail.com. Thank you, Linda, for joining us. I appreciate it so much. You are such a sweetheart.
Thank you.
God is good.
Yes, He is.
Mm-hmm.